The following program portrays explicit contact with the unsavory. If you suffer from sitting on a high horse, this show might not be right for you. Check with your local air traffic controller.
Proclaiming the truth in the highways and byways of the world. Fighting for justice in the dark alleys of politics. Raising the voice of resistance to a fevered pitch. And he knows where to find the best and worst jail food in America. Randall Terry.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the nation's number one lunatic fringe Tea Party television show. We've got such a great show for you already. I'm so excited. An exclusive interview with U.S. Senate candidate Daniel Bongino. He's the Secret Service guy who used to protect Obama. Now he's running for the U.S. Senate against a left-wing lunatic liberal from Maryland. And cutting-edge analysis concerning Michelle Bachmann, Herman Cain, Perry, Romney, all of the above. A little wake-up call to the Tea Party people. Here's my suggestion, okay, Tea Party friends? Try coffee! Try some coffee in the morning! Today's program brought to you in part by Black Walnut Ice Cream. Yes, it's not just the flavor of the week, but it's got staying power. And by Sugar Daddy Candy. Sugar Daddy. Whether you're a young black disenfranchised man on the south side of Chicago or a rich white yuppie Wall Street broker who can't make his Mercedes payment in New York City, Sugar Daddy will take care of you. I'll be right back after a quick word from my friend, Sir Reginald Ling. Just turn the thing on. I got something to say. I remember the days my grandpappy told me when a man could have his own fishing pole and fish for whatever kind of fish he wanted. Yeah, you teach a man how to fish, he won't go hungry. But now the government says, no, give us your fishing pole. We might give it to you when we give you a license, and we'll tell you what kind of fish you can catch. But if you really want to be in tall cotton with Barack Hussein Obama, he'll give you a fish every day. You ain't even got to worry about fishing. Somebody else will do the fishing for you. Let me tell you something, people. You can have one fish a day for the rest of your life, and guess what? It's going to be carp. Yeah, who wants to eat carp every day when you could be fishing for bluegill and for trout and for smallmouth and largemouth bass, even a great muskellunge? People, when the government says they're going to give you a fish every day, it smells fishy to me. Listen, don't take the deal. Welcome to the program, friend. It is I, your servant, Randall Terry. We have so much to talk about and so little time. So strap on, because this ride is going to be rough. Don't try this at home. I'm a professional. This is a closed track. Before I get into the content of today's show, let me tell you something. God Almighty, who made heaven and earth, has a destiny for you. He has a destiny for your life. And it involves more than you sitting in front of a television screen or a computer screen or downloading this show on an iPod and other shows like this. It's not enough that we see what's going on, that we hear about what's going on. But God's destiny for you is that you impact what's going on, that you have a hand, a role, a place in the destiny of this nation, your community, your family, the people that you work with, the people that you go to church with. We are called not to be a thermometer. Oh, what's going on around me? We're called to be thermostats. We set the agenda. We set the temperature. We determine what's going to be talked about. So please, think of yourself as a game changer. God's hand is on you. God's hand is on you. All right, let's talk about those things. All right, just so you understand what's coming up in today's program, I'm going to have some very serious words to my friends in the Tea Party movement. We're going to look at the Florida straw poll. We have an exclusive interview with Daniel Bongino. He was just on Fox, he was just on MSNBC, and now he's gonna be here on the nation's number one Tea Party television show. Oh yes, exclusive interview, Daniel Bongino for US Senate. Florida, oh, there's so much to talk about in this polling data. It's a little bit confusing, but what I wanna do is get you to think, okay? Just stop and think. Number one, the Florida straw poll results are in. A straw poll is like a beauty pageant, okay? It's a beauty pageant. It doesn't mean whoever because untied, by the way, it doesn't mean whoever wins is going to be the winner of the presidency. It's not even a scientifically accurate polling mechanism, all right? When Zogby or one of the other pollsters does a sampling, they've got a minus 3%, 3.5%, plus or minus scientific accuracy, depending on their polling sample size. When you have a straw poll, people get together who just want to come together, all right? They drive in, they vote. It's a beauty pageant. But it has PR value, and it shows who's got momentum. It shows who's gaining enthusiasm. For example, in the Iowa straw poll in August, who won? Michelle Bachmann, almost as a runaway. And what was Michelle Bachmann in Florida, in the Florida straw poll that just happened? 1%, okay? She goes from the top of the pack in Iowa to dead last in Florida. Now, does that mean she's only gonna get 1% of the vote when the primary happens? No. It means right now, though, that as far as the beauty pageant is concerned, she needs a new dress. She needs a new makeup artist. She needs a new hairdo, okay? Rick Perry, he came in late in the game, shot to the top of the pack. Tea Partiers, 45% of the Tea Party favored him, okay? By the time the Florida straw poll happened, he only had 10% of Tea Party support. Dropped from 45 to 10, and in the polling of the straw poll itself, he went from what should have been first place to fourth place! Fourth! Behind Newt Gingrich, okay? He was at 9%, Newt was at 10. Herman Cain and Mitt Romney duking it out at the front of the pack. Another problem with the polling data that's out there, is that pollsters are lazy and they're trying to save money. They can easier find out who are registered voters than to find out their voting history in primaries, okay? Because the issue is, who is a likely Republican primary voter? That's very different than a registered voter or even a registered Republican, because most Republicans, get this, don't vote in the primary. Yeah. So it's a really big deal who is ahead in the polls of registered, or rather of likely Republican primary voters. And right now, Rick Perry is in third. Zogby has Herman Cain in first. Fox has Mitt Romney in first. Now, the interesting thing about that is this. Perry's numbers are dropping like a rock. It's basically as if Michelle Bachmann, with her big rock, tied herself or chained herself to the Rick Perry rock, okay? So Michelle, she jumps overboard by hiring Ed Rollins as her campaign manager, and she's going bloop, 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 to the bottom of the ocean. Rick Perry's standing up there thinking, hey, I look good. I got this suit on. Little does he know, he's got a chain on his ankle. It's attached to the Michelle Bachmann rock. And all of a sudden, Perry goes, whoop, shoop, and you see him go off camera, boom, boom, in he goes. Now, interestingly, there was a pulley system down at the bottom, and Herman Cain shoots out of the water like he was some mythical Greek god. Who is this man? I am Herman Cain, chief executive officer of a pizza company. And I'm good. I speak in snappy little sound bites. I'm not afraid to say things that are politically incorrect. And look at me, I'm Black Walnut. That's what he calls himself. It's hysterical. This guy is hysterical. He's a stitch and he's intelligent and he knows how to speak in sound bites that create energy and enthusiasm. So we've got Michelle Bachmann and Rick Perry dropping to the bottom, and their pulley system is brought Herman Cain up. And now Herman Cain is in a battle for first place with the white Obama. Yes, Mitt Romney. Let's just call him the white Obama, because there's basically no policy difference between him and Barack Hussein Obama, okay? One gentleman has a dark complexion skin. One gentleman is a lily white complexion skin. But yeah, when it comes to policy, give me $50 and you can kill your baby. Who said that? Mitt Romney. Yeah, not Barack Obama. The pro-life community is off its rocker. They're all concerned about whether or not there'll be child killing in Obamacare. Meanwhile, Mitt Romney paid for child killing. Hello, are you hearing me, people? $50 copay. You have a little baby you don't want? Don't you worry. We'll put that child where it belongs. First in a dumpster, then in a landfill. The blood of innocent babies is crying from the ground against Mitt Romney. And there are Christian people, pro-life people, who are throwing their support behind him. Are you brain dead? Is your soul so calloused that you can't even feel the heartbeat of God himself? Are your ears so deaf that you don't hear the sound of blood? Hello? Wake up. Wake up. I've got to take a break. I don't even know how long I've gone, but I know that I've got to take a break. My cameraman is also doing double duty on sound, and he's basically not with me today. So, I'll be right back. Coming up, Daniel Bongino, and some very strong words of encouragement to the Tea Party, of which I am a key player and the host of the nation's number one Tea Party television show. So when I've got something to say, hey, you better listen.
Randall always liked my father because of his wit. An old friend of Dad's one morning asked him, "Hi, Ed, how have you been?" And Dad said, "Ever since I got up this morning, I've been sick in bed on two chairs."
Hi, Joe Costello here, founder of Kylea Health and Energy. I've been making superb nutritional supplements for over 15 years, and from day one, I've partnered with Randall Terry, helping to fund his invaluable work in reclaiming our country's biblical and godly roots. I want to share with you a product that has changed hundreds of thousands of lives since its inception.
Introducing the Total Living Drinks, Greens and Berry, the ultimate superfood formulas that provide you the 9 essential areas of nutrition your body needs on a daily basis. Each serving of the Total Living Drink provides the life-giving phytonutrients that come from the equivalent of 5 servings of organic vegetables and berries, enzymes for better digestion and nutrient absorption, protein for building lean muscle mass so you can burn more fat for fuel, probiotics for better intestinal function, herbs for building energy and stamina, antioxidants for maximum immune function and disease prevention, and all the vitamins and minerals you need for slowing down aging and maximum health. You would have to take 30 to 40 capsules each day and spend almost $10 a day to match the over 30,000 milligrams of total nutrition in each scoop of the Total Living Drink. Order right now and get started on the amazing Total Living Drink. They come in 2 delicious flavors, Total Living Drink Greens and Total Living Drink Berry. And every single dollar we receive, we give a generous amount to Randall Terry's organization to help further his work and further the kingdom. Visit us online at the address on your screen and receive an online discount or call the toll-free number. Call today, and for the daily price of a latte, you can get back on the road to better health and energy with Kylea's Total Living Drink.
Moments with Moses. He stiffened his neck and hardened his heart against turning to the Lord, the God of Israel.
Welcome back, friend. In just a couple of minutes, our exclusive interview with Daniel Bongino. He's the former Secret Service agent, protected President Bush and Obama on their private security detail, okay? He resigned. Walked away from it, walked away from his retirement, his health care, everything to run for the U.S. Senate against, I think it's Ben Carter up there in Maryland, left-wing lunatic, baby-killing loser. Oh, this is going to be exciting. You're going to want to see this interview. But first, I've got to talk to my Tea Party friends, pro-life friends, especially you Tea Party folks. So listen to me. The Tea Party right now is rudderless, okay, and captainless. It's a big, terrifying ship, okay? Like the Bismarck. Do you remember the history of the Bismarck? Do you remember it in World War II? The Bismarck was the largest ship in the world. And some English pilots got lucky and got a torpedo in and disabled the rudder. It couldn't turn. It was just this massive ship doing loops in the ocean. And then the Allies finally figured out what was going on. So what did the Germans do? They scuttled it. They sank it. Rather than let it be captured by the British, they sunk their own ship. We are in trouble in the Tea Party movement. And you know why? Because the guiding philosophy has not been established for the Tea Party. And certainly, human leadership has not been established. And without those two things, you don't have a focused military or a focused group of activists. You've got an unruly mob, okay? And you don't have a fire with a fireplace that you can cook your food and warm your house. You have a wildfire that can burn down your barn, kill all your animals, burn up your house, kill you. And how do I know this is true? Well, I'll tell you how I know it's true. When Perry can go from 45% of Tea Party people like him to 10% in a matter of a couple weeks, what that means is that the Tea Party folks are behaving like regular voters. They're not asking tough questions. They're not doing a background on policy positions. Oh, Rick Perry, he's from Texas. Wasn't George Bush from Texas? Oh, he says he's going to lower my taxes. He thinks that the Tea Party is cool. I'm for him. And then he doesn't do well in a couple of debates, and you bail out on him? What is that? Are you a high school girl, a high school cheerleader? Or do you have some substance? Find out where these candidates stand on positions, entitlements, child killing, homosexual marriage, homosexuals in the military, drilling for oil in Anwar off the coast of Florida, phasing out Social Security. These are the things that we will live and die on as a nation. And those policies, specific policies, they matter, okay? So friends, in the Tea Party, we've got to stop this nonsense, because if we are a rabble, sooner or later we will be dispersed or we will be absorbed by someone. You hearing me? Content matters. Content is king. Find out the policies. When we come back from this break, we're going to hear from policies from a U.S. candidate for Senate, or a Senate for U.S. candidate, something like that, named Daniel Bongino. You're going to love this. Can the guy who does the teleprompter please help me? Where's Obama's teleprompter guy?
And your platform will be no property taxes, no IRS, no Social Security, no abortion, and no homosexuals. Good luck with that, buddy.
And your camera tactics don't scare me.
Hi, Joe Costello here, founder of Kylea Health and Energy. I want to share with you a product that has changed hundreds of thousands of lives.
Introducing the Total Living Drinks, Greens and Berry, the ultimate superfood formulas that provide you the 9 daily essential areas of nutrition your body needs. Each scoop provides the life-giving phytonutrients that come from the equivalent of 5 servings of organic vegetables and berries, probiotics for better intestinal function, antioxidants for disease prevention, and vitamins and minerals for establishing maximum health. Order now and get started on the Total Living Drink. When you do, a generous gift will go to Randall Terry's organization to help further his work and further the kingdom. Order online and receive an online discount or call the toll-free number. Call today and enjoy maximum health and energy.
The flame of Christian ethics is still our best guide. Only on this basis can we reconcile the rights of the individual with the demands of society. Sir Winston Churchill.
From our recent trip to Israel, at the Wailing Wall, our interview with Daniel Bongino. I'm with Daniel Bongino. God bless you. Spell that for us.
B-O-N-G-I-N-O.
Nice. Did you have jokes when you were a kid about that?
You get the Bon Jovi jokes, the standard stuff. But that's how people remember.
What about B-I-N-G-O? Anyone do that with the bingo dog?
Some school teachers when I was a kid as a method of torture, I'm sure.
Daniel is running for the U.S. Senate, Republican, Maryland, and your Democratic opponent is?
Ben Cardin.
Who's not popular right now.
No, he's not. What's he running on? 9.2% unemployment, a terrible private business environment in Maryland? I mean, what particular issue is he running on?
I'm close with Barry.
Yeah, maybe. I think he's running from that as well.
Well, you didn't run from it, but you actually served our president honorably, both President Obama and President Bush, in the Secret Service.
That's right. I did 5 years in the Presidential Protection Division, 3 years of President Bush and 2 years of President Obama. It was a great experience.
I bet it was. And now you packed it all in?
I resigned. I didn't retire to do this. You know, we can't keep losing this game in the locker room.
When you say you resigned, you didn't retire, does that mean you gave up all your years as far as benefits and you're going to have a retirement fund and all that?
Yeah, that's all gone.
You're not vested.
No, I'm not.
You literally walked away from it.
I'm a middle-class guy. I didn't win the lotto. If you go to the FEC website, I'm a declared candidate. You can see my my records, my financial records, and you'll see that I'm a middle-class guy, of middle-class means, who decided it was time to get out of the locker room and play this game on the field.
God bless you, man.
Oh, I honor you.
You have raised a little less than $100,000 so far. What's your goal financially?
Well, we'd like to do between $6 and $8 million by the time the election comes up in November. We're on target. We've only been fundraising for about 4 to 5 weeks. We had a large media presence initially on Fox News and CNN, and that took up a lot of our time the first 2 weeks of the campaign. So the last 4 weeks, we've been focusing on fundraising. We did very well. We had two very successful events, and we're right on target. We've met all of our metrics so far.
Friends, you're looking at his website on our screen right now. Please feel free to go there, visit. If you want to make a campaign contribution, please do it. The place of killing children in America. If a bill came up that said it will be a criminal act to kill an unborn baby from conception until birth, would you sign it?
I'm pro-life.
Would you vote for it?
I am pro-life. Yes.
So that'd be a yes.
That's a yes.
Homosexual marriage, the two hot button issues. Should marriage be between a man and a woman?
I am pro-traditional marriage. There's marriage and the redefinition of marriage. Although I have no personal problem with homosexual relationship, I don't think anyone should. These people are valued children of God as well, but I am pro-traditional marriage.
Entitlement reform.
Social Security, Medicare, big problems. Now, the evil privatized word comes up all the time, but it's funny. Social Security was initially instituted because the government was going to save for you. Now, the government...
Well, they didn't save it. They done spent it all. It's all gone.
Well, they were going to save for you because you weren't going to save yourself, but they spent it already. So I never quite understood. I find it perplexing when we talk about putting people's money in their own hands that becomes an issue. They say, oh, don't use the word privatized. Why is that? They've already spent your money.
Right.
The system's broke. Now, having said that, I do believe it should be for folks 55 and younger, and I can't say that enough, because those promises have already been made to those folks. That was America's greatest generation, and I think those folks should be able to plan their lives.
55 and older.
55 and older should be left untouched.
Right.
That's
right.
Correct. 55 and younger, right. The changes.
Yes.
We should have privatized accounts, 3% a year and a deduction at a market rate of interest. The rate is at 67 years old, leave you at about $22,000 a year, which is $2,000 more than the average now.
Well, and if you die, you get to leave it to your kids.
Yeah, that's
my father died when he was 60 years old.
Right.
The Social Security people sent me a $255 check to bury him.
Right, unless they moved the death tax down to $22,000, then you won't be
$255. I put void on it, and wrote some nasty note, told him to take it to the hot place and send it back. So, all right, end of the day, and I'm going to tell you straight up, I don't want to ambush you, but I believe that when you put a gun to another citizen's head and you say, you're going to pay for my kid's doctor bill or my kid's education or my kid's anything,
right?
It's theft. I mean, socialism by definition is a transfer of wealth by the force of the government, the threat of law, the threat of going to jail if you don't
right.
pony up.
Right.
So I believe we should actually do away with all redistribution of wealth, every last bit of it. Do you have any thought on that?
Well, when you look at failed socialist models, which is all of them, because there's never one that succeeded. I mean, really, can you show me one area in human history where socialism's worked?
They hell.
Rely on, hell.
In hell.
Maybe, right, where they have it, and heaven where they don't need it. I forget who said that, but, you know, we look at
Winston
it.
Winston Churchill.
Right, Churchill, right, that's right. I've read that quote quite a bit. Third-party payers, price controls and coercion, every time. First, it's the third-party payer. The government picks up the tab. Then it's price controls, because that never works, because you can't control a price. A price is just an agreement.
Right.
And then what do? Coercion. The
right.
last resort of every failed regime. And you see it all in the Affordable Care Act.
Mm.
You have the price controls through IPAB, and then you have to join. Why do you have to join? If the system's so wonderful,
right.
why do you have to join?
Right.
The answer is because it's not wonderful, and they know it's going to fail. But if you have to join, it brings everybody into the failure collectively. Let's make this a citizen-centric economy, not a government-centric economy. It's worked every time. Remember, you know it, I know it. It's worked every time throughout human history.
Your top three issues?
Economy, healthcare, education, every time. And they're all related. They're really not three issues. They're one issue broken down into three separate parts.
Tune in tomorrow for the second half of that exclusive interview. I'll be right back with a word from one of our founders.
Because he cleaves to me in love, I will deliver him. I will protect him because he knows my name. When he calls to me, I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble and will rescue him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation.
Hi, Joe Costello here, founder of Kylea Health and Energy. I want to share with you a product that has changed hundreds of thousands of lives.
Introducing the Total Living Drinks, Greens and Berry, the ultimate superfood formulas that provide you the 9 daily essential areas of nutrition your body needs. Each scoop provides the life-giving phytonutrients that come from the equivalent of 5 servings of organic vegetables and berries, probiotics for better intestinal function, antioxidants for disease prevention, and vitamins and minerals for establishing maximum health. Order now and get started on the Total Living Drink. When you do, a generous gift will go to Randall Terry's organization to help further his work and further the kingdom. Order online and receive an online discount or call the toll-free number. Call today and enjoy maximum health and energy.
John Adams said, "The true source of our sufferings has been our timidity." Oh my goodness. Think of Herman Cain, think of Michelle Bachmann. She got timid and she plummeted. Herman Cain, he's not being timid. He's speaking the truth. He's telling people what he believes and he's shooting up in the polls. Let us learn from John Adams. Let us learn from these two examples and let us throw off timidity as if it were shackles. And let us embrace boldness and courage and declare the truth without equivocation.